Maybe we shouldn't speak until the representative arrives.
No, I'm sorry, but I can't do this. It's not what I expected of you, Anthony.
You want to make a change now so you can satisfy your ego. You never care about me. You never will.
Anthony, don't say any more.
I'm a worker from social services. I understand you want to be legally emancipated from your parents.
There isn't anything more I want more than this. I can't stand to be with them.
Well then, tell me why you want to leave your parents.
Why don't they tell us the story of when he found out she was pregnant?
When we found out she was pregnant, we were happy, like any married couple should be. End of story.
Oh, happy? Why don't you tell us the story again?
Mr. and Mrs. Wright? Okay, fine. Hello?
Nicholas?
Hey Judy, what's up?
Yeah, I have to tell you something.
Yeah, sure, go ahead.
Never mind. Can you come over tonight?
Alright, I'll be there around 7.
Yeah, sounds great. Bye.
Don't freak out, but I'm pregnant.
And Mr. Wright, how did you react to this?
Well,
so, Mr. Wright, you were happy to have a child?
Yes, to an extent. It was always something we wanted, but after we got married. I guess it was a big step in my life, but we were happy to go through with it.
What? Hold on. You wanted me? How come you never treated me as a child you always wanted? What about all those times you told me I was a mistake?
You were a bloody mistake. Do you think I was prepared to get your mother through such a thing like an abortion? No. We decided to go through with this mistake. We didn't have half a thought that it would turn out to be such an ungrateful child as you.
That's enough!
How about if my client tells the story?
Fine. Anthony, tell me when you were first angry at your parents.
Alright. I think it happened when I was 7. At my first little league football game.
Hello?
Mr. Wright, the boss is from ANZ are
what?
Here.
No, that we had it scheduled for Tuesday.
But then he called today and said he couldn't come on Tuesday.
You could have told me first, you know.
I did this morning.
For God's sake, I promised my little boy I'd be at his football game.
I'm sure he'd understand.
Alright. I hate this. But just give his coach a call and I'll tell him to take Anthony home, right?
Whatever you need, boss.
I'll send you the number. Cheers.
Promise me that you'd make it, and once again, you embarrass me.
For God's sake, Anthony, do you realize how hard it is for me to work to provide for a little brat like you? Just go up to your room.
I was a busy man. I had work to do. Work that would keep a roof over your head, food in your belly, and you at school. That's hardly my fault.
Hardly your fault? What about all the other games? Had a meeting then too? What about when we made it to the finals? You said you had nothing to do, but you still didn't make it because it was your friend's birthday. Promised him a drink out. What about then, Dad? What about then?
How did you know about that?
How? Michael saw you.
Michael? That little blonde brat? I thought I told you not to hang out with him.
He's my friend. He actually cares about me.
We're your parents. Of course we care about you.
Enough! We're moving on.
Thank
you. Anthony, when you were 8, you were diagnosed with dyslexia. So how did you react, Mr. Wright?
How? I was fine with it.
That's a load of crap. What do you mean, Anthony?
I wasn't finished.
Mr. Wright, calm down. Anthony, how did you react?
Don't be allowed to speak. What if he was lying? He's making us look bad.
Why would I lie? If you cared for me, or even wanted to, these two wouldn't even be here.
Dyslexia! Our own child, Judy, has bloody dyslexia! What is wrong with you?
How is this my fault?
It is! Now go to your room. I do not want to see you.
You don't have to be so harsh on him.
I'm sorry, honey, that all I want for our child is the best. This dyslexia is just holding him back from being great, like me and my father and his father before him. Isn't that so hard? Just, honey, don't tell me how to raise my child.
From what I understand from Anthony, Mrs. Wright, you were also abused by Nicholas?
I'm sorry, but yeah, he does have anger issues, but I knew that. But you can't take our only child away from us.
sense.
Well, thank you. Anthony, you're going to need to come with me.
No, please, sir. This...
I've heard enough, Nicholas.
Well, that's it? He's just leaving us?
Well, nothing is final yet, but for Anthony's safety, you're going to need to come with me.
Can't take him away! See? Come on!
Jim.
Well, you're all going down with me!
Jim.
Yes!
One, action.
Oh, happy? Tell us a story then. One! Leave it.
Hold it back!
Action!
And you should have showed it.
Show it.
Action!
Well, when I was 8.
Two. You gotta be talking to him. 3, 2, 1, action.
Why would I lie? If I... Well, why would I lie if you care for me?